serious.
Oh, fish.
Boy, this steelhead took it deep, man. Took it deep. All the way in there. Great. Great.
He probably liked it a little bit.
So that fish was on a bobber dogging setup. So what I got here is just a fish fueled float, obviously in this big, big water. I'm running the large float. It's gonna allow me to fish a little bit more weight and slow it down just a tiny bit. Down to a three-way swivel with a Dave's Tangle Free. These things are incredible, man. They just work so good. They kind of keep, I think steel moves smoother along the bottom without getting hung up. And so those things are really, really efficient in that way. And then I'm just going down to my yarny here. So I just got a yarn ball tied up with an egg loop on it. So that way we can add some shrimp with a bait button on it. And then we'll go down to a B&R soft bead, 20 mil B&R soft bead here. And I'll show you guys how I tie this knot, because it's a pretty cool little knot and there's a reason I use it. So you might not be able to see the knot itself, but I just doubled the line up. It's kind of like the Duncan loop. It's just slightly different. I got scent all over my hands. And then I just wrap back down towards the knot. And then you take that tag in and go back through that little loop you made. And then you just kind of snug it up and it'll create this loop. And it's really cool because once you attach this loop and snug it down, I like to pull it tight and then pull the tag in tight. But once you create this loop on the hook there, I can put some pressure on this knot and don't do it with your teeth. Your dentist will probably get upset, but I like to, then it leaves that little loop. So I can take this thing on and off, and it's really cool when you're adding like a shrimp to this. You put your shrimp on, your bait button on, and then just slide your loop back on and you're back in business. So super easy and efficient way. And then I'll grab my 20 mil soft bead here. And then with these, I have an inline bead tied on there. So is what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna try to get this as centered as possible and try to keep it as centered as possible so it doesn't wobble and tangle on you. And then I just go nice and slow so the rubber doesn't get burnt and tore up. And then that just sits right above there like so. And that fish will grab it, hook pulls through, and just grabs them in the corner of the mouth every time. It's awesome. Most efficient way, great technique for high water.